it as indication, and therefore it is helpful to see it first on our spectrum analyzer to have a visual idea on what's really going on. Okay, so the next step is I have now connected my signal generator to the radio, and you might have seen that the radio is adjusted to 14.1 megahertz on the 20 meter band, and for the moment in time I'm not putting out any power to the radio, and that is the reason why we still, and you can hear it, we still have only noise, so there is definitely no signal. Okay, now I leave here the speaker on, and I switch on my audio generator, and the radio is set to AM, so additional to that I use 30% modulated AM signal, and always when we are testing, we are using, not always, but most of the time, we are using a 1 kilohertz audio tone, right? And that is what I've adjusted here, 30% modulation and 1 kilohertz audio tone. And that is what we now send, if you will, to the radio. And the radio needs to receive the signal and needs to demodulate the signal that in the end, at our speaker, we can win back our audio, because that is what we want. So on our transmission, we have high frequencies, so that is how we carry our audio signal to distant end, and at distant end, at the receiver, we have to bring back or win back, if you will, our audio signal, and therefore our receiver needs to amplify the signal, and the signal, the high frequency signal needs to get demodulated, and at the end, what we want is our audio signal, because otherwise we would not be able to listen to anybody who is talking to radio, right? Okay, so now switching back to speaker, and now I am switching in my signal, and what you hear and see is, here is our 1 kilohertz, okay, and what you see here is that we really have here 1 kilohertz signal. So watch this here once again. I switch it off, and you see here our 1 kilohertz tone. So our audio tone is disappearing again. So we only have here again our noise, our static noise. So I do not take here the blue line into account. So it is only the second my audio gear here is having for stereo testing. So do not take this here into account. We are not interested here. Interested in blue line, only in our red line. Okay. So once again, back at. You hear the signal is still very, very noisy. So we hear there is a 1 kilohertz tone, and we clearly can see it here, okay? But you hear that there is still a lot of noise. And the signal, I switch it here to dummy, that is easier for us. The signal, which is still very, very much in the noise, is very difficult to understand. So what we really would like to have is a signal which is strong enough to be able to overcome our noise level, so that the distance, if you will, between the noise and our audio level is that huge that we only hear the tone. And let me tell you that what we have here, so once again, all the noise in the background with only our little signal here is a minus 115 dBm signal. So that is really a very low or very weak signal which the radio is able to pick, but the voice wouldn't be easy to understand, so that would be I don't know, radio 3 or radio 4, radio 3 or radio 2 signal maybe, but definitely no radio 5 signal, which is the qualification on the audio signal if you're giving somebody on your radio a 5.9. So that means 5 is standing for a very clear audio, and 9 is a signal which you're reading on your S meter. And always when you tell somebody on the radio, yeah, your signal is 5.9, that means that you really have a very clear audio, okay? And in this case here, that may be radio 3, I don't know. So that is not very good. It becomes harder and harder to understand. But now, we are going back here to a speaker that you can see our signal, that you can see our noise. And now, let me increase here my signal. And watch here, and listen to the tone, it's getting louder and louder. And what you see, our signal is getting stronger and stronger. Okay, so now we are at minus 90 dBm and almost no noise in the background. And you may remember, minus 73 is an S9 signal on the radio. Now we are at minus 80, and I go straight to minus 73. I know the tone is annoying, but we need it to get the difference. And now, if you listen to the tone, there is no noise anymore in the background. I switch off the speaker because it's really annoying. We are back on dummy, but we have the same here on our screen. What is the difference? The difference is, this is a minus 73 dBm signal. So that means it is S9, okay? And now you see if somebody is producing an S9 level, normally this station would get over with radio 5, because with an S9 high frequency level, the audio should be able to get out of the signal with very good quality, and that is definitely what we can hear here. So it is more or less it is VHF quality, if you will, right? So and you see it here as well. So if this here is our noise, or not, if it is a noise, you see that now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there is a difference of 60 dB here. So minimum here for our tester here, and that is now the difference between, you know, the noise level and it's a signal. But on the other end, what you can see here as well is that you see this here. And what you see here are harmonics of our 1 kilohertz tone. And so this is a total harmonic distortion, what you can see here. So this is always getting into the final signal, if you like, and therefore if you have here a very high total harmonic distortion level, that means that it's the sign which we would like to reproduce at pure sine could be distorted by maybe a bad audio stage or a bad, I don't know, front end stage, whatever. So there are so many parts in the radio which are able to destroy here your THD level. So you always want to have a pure sign. As better your THD level is, as better the audio quality is. If you have a high THD level, then, you know, at the end you have a completely distorted signal, even if you have a strong radio signal. So, for instance, you simply can have an S9 signal on your S meter, but if something is wrong in your radio signal path, you may have a huge THD level, and that means the audio is still very bad. You can't understand it, right? And therefore, but that would be the second step. The SINET or SINET testing is very nice, but we just want to start with signal to noise and how we can test it very easy. For the moment in time, it is interesting for you to understand what this signal to noise ratio is, okay? And once again, I switch the speaker back. You hear no noise in the background, so we only have a pure sign, right? And now, when you're down with the radio signal, you again see that our noise is getting up, and the signal to noise ratio is dropping more and more. And you hear that we have now more noise in the background, much more noise. And you see, it's getting smaller and smaller until the signal finally completely disappears in the noise. Now, the signal, here we have the signal, and now you see, or you may be able to understand that now the signal to noise ratio is very, very bad. So you do not hear the signal any longer, so you only have here our noise. The radio is not able to pick the audio.